How to silence the internal talk. Like, and how to redirect the internal talk. last off season. This is it. This is the perfect, this is almost surreal. 10 weeks, and he already, did I do enough? What, did I train hard enough? Did I do this? That last guy was really good. I didn't expect someone to be that good in this division. What if I do that? I repeat nervous. I was judging before. I didn't get to warm up properly. You know, I didn't have breakfast this morning. I was too nervous. Is that going to help me? I need to go to the toilet. Why is my blood so small all of a sudden? I can't get to the toilet in 5 minutes. Follow?
Hey.
I think I drank too much. My mum's watching. My mum's never seen me do karate before. You've got 100 things going through your brain. And none of them are helping you. Now you can't have zero internal talk. You can't just go in like a Zen monk and think nothing. If anyone knows anything about transcendental meditation, they'll say, it's got nothing to do with thinking nothing. Because that's impossible. It's literally impossible to think nothing. Am I thinking nothing? Cool, I just thought of something. Nothing. Cool, hang on, that's something. It's impossible. So you've got to have talk all the time. So all you can do is consciously put the right talk in, or subconsciously have the gap talk. I don't care how many tournaments you've done, you're not controlling the talk. In a World Cup or a national titles or a big tournament, you're going to have too much going on, and it's going to make you rush, it's going to make you nervous, it's going to make you miss your senses, etc. So I can't stop how much talk is going to go when you're walking into the room, but the first thing we're going to do is take charge of that mind at the moment you bow. Some of you may have done this before, because I know I've said some videos over to we're going to practice it now a few times, and then we're going to work out how to control our self-talk through the kata as well. And even though you're going to practice it today, with this kata, I want you to do it every kata, every training session, all the time. Now, the biggest mistake people do, the biggest mistake people make in a tournament is they rush. They want to be fast, they want to get out of there as quick as they can. Or they're so paranoid about making the stances are so perfect. I just want to get out of there. Get out of that stance. Properly ugly, so I'll just get out of it so they can't see it's ugly. They're seeing it's ugly. And it's even more ugly, we should not stop. Hey. Who's judged here? Anyone ever thought that was really quick, that card? Or maybe a good score? No. Has anyone ever thought that was even messy because they rushed? They gave them a bad score. You don't want that, right? So the first thing you want to say to yourself, and we'll show you how to do it, is to take your time. Take your time. Right? In fact, I'll do the second one. First thing you want to say is relax. Because all that heartbeat, boom, 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 produces adrenaline, and then that's why you're in a rush, that's why you're getting stiff. When you have adrenaline, your shoulders lift. So I want you to say to yourself, relax. And I don't want you to go, relax! Something for you that you know in the car that I'm giving you. Could be your stances, could be sometimes you get a bit stuck in getting out of blocks and like you explode. I say enjoy yourself. Enjoy. Whatever it is for you, could be breathing. Could be whatever. Give you 10 seconds to think of your third one now. Think of something for you. Could be angles. See what you mean? Sometimes people get angles. Remind yourself good angles, so you get your 45s. Quick, 10 seconds, 10, 9. Think of one that's really good just for you. 9 out of 10